I'd like to welcome everyone this morning. As the sitting is about to convene, may I kindly remind you that applause is not allowed during the sitting. Thank you very much. In accordance with Section 83(1) of the Virgin Islands Constitution Order 2007, UKSI 2007, number 1678, that the sessions of the House of Assembly shall be held at such times and places as the governor may appoint by proclamation published in the Gazette. We will now have prayers by Pastor Simon.
Our heads as we pray. Almighty Father, great God of the universe, how excellent is your name in all the earth. We praise you, we magnify you, we worship you, because you are God all by yourself. You are the minister of ministers, the leader of leaders, the premier of premiers, the governor of governors, the King of kings, the Lord of lords, the God of gods. We recognize you today as the one who has governed this territory with your sovereignty. We thank you for the wonderful blessings that you have bestowed upon us and for the wonderful reality that one government can replace another without bloodshed and carnage and violence. We pray, O God, that your peace, like a perpetual river, would continue to be bestowed upon this territory. We pray that you would continue to bless us. May you protect our ports. May you flourish our fields. May you improve and increase our industry. May you protect and prosper your people. We pray that today, that you, the God, who sent Samuel down to the house of Jesse to anoint for him a king after your own heart, that today you would lift the horn, your instrument of anointing, and pour out on those to be set aside the oil of wisdom, the oil of vision, the oil of good governance, so that such wonderful decisions would be made during this season that generations yet unborn would be blessed in these Virgin Islands. We pray your blessings upon the Premier. We pray your blessings upon the entire government. We pray your blessings upon the leader of the opposition and all the members of the House of Assembly. And as today you set aside, I pray that this would be more than a civic situation, but allow the Spirit of the living God to permeate the lives of those who have been elected to lead. I pray, O God, that your wisdom would be so powerful and palpable that not even one thought, not even one word, not even one decision would be made without it being ordained by God. We pray your blessings upon the proceedings today. We pray your blessings on everyone present today. And we pray, O God, that as you pour out heaven's benediction, that your blessings would be felt and make all the difference today and every day of our lives. This is our prayer with thanksgiving in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen and amen. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor Simon. Please sit. Item number 2, election of speaker. In accordance with standing order number 4, of the standing orders of the House of Assembly of the Virgin Islands, I now invite the Leader of Government Business, the Premier, to make a nomination.
Thank you, Madam Clerk. I beg to nominate Ms. Ingrid Moses to be Speaker of this Honorable House.
I beg to second the motion.
I now invite the Leader of the Opposition to make a nomination.
Members of the Opposition, Madam Clerk, make no nomination.
In accordance with Standing Order number 4 of the Standing Orders of the House of Assembly of the Virgin Islands, I declare Ingrid Moses Scatliff elected as Speaker, and I now call upon the Premier to move a motion that Ms. Ingrid Moses Scatliff do take the chair as Speaker of the House of Assembly.
Madam Clerk, I move that Ms. Ingrid Moses do take the chair as Speaker.
I second the motion.
Item number 3, Oath of Allegiance.
I, Ingrid Moses Scatliff, do solemnly and sincerely affirm that I will be faithful and bear true allegiance to Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II, her heirs and successors according to law.
I'll also ask Ms. Moses Scatliff to affirm for due execution of office.
I, Ingrid Moses Scatliff, do solemnly and sincerely affirm and declare that I will well and truly serve Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II and the people of the Virgin Islands in the office of Speaker.
Item number 4, election of Deputy Speaker.
Whenever there is a vacancy in the office of Deputy Speaker, the House shall, in accordance with Section 69, Subsection 4 of the Virgin Islands Constitution, Order 2007, proceed to elect a member to be Deputy Speaker. The election of the Deputy Speaker shall be conducted in a similar manner to the election of the Speaker, save that the Speaker shall preside. I now invite the Leader of Government Business, the Premier, to make a nomination.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I beg to nominate the Honorable Delois Christopher as Deputy Speaker of this Honorable House.
Madam Speaker, I second the motion.
In accordance with Standing Order number 5 of the Standing Orders of this Honorable House, I now declare Mrs. Delois Christopher as Deputy Speaker.
Item number 5, Oaths of Allegiance, Deputy Speaker.
I, Delois Christopher, do solemnly and sincerely affirm that I will be faithful and bear true allegiance to Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II, her heirs and successors, according to law. I, Delois Christopher, do solemnly and sincerely affirm and declare that I will well and truly serve Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II and the people of the Virgin Islands in the office of member for the 5th District.
Item number 6, Oaths of Allegiance members. I will now call their names in alphabetical order, and they will step forward to take their oaths of allegiance. Mrs. Alvaro Maduro Keynes.
I, Alvaro Maduro Keynes, do solemnly and sincerely affirm that I will be faithful and bear true allegiance to Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II, her heirs and successors according to law. I, Alvaro Maduro Keynes, do solemnly and sincerely affirm and declare that I will well and truly serve Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II and the people of the Virgin Islands in the office of Member for the 6th District.
Honorable Alvaro Maduro Keynes has been duly appointed a member of the House of Assembly.
Mr. Archibald Christian.
I, Archibald C. Christian, do swear that I will faithful and bear true allegiance to Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II, her heirs and successors, according to law, so help me God. I, Archibald C. Christian, do swear that I will truly serve Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II and the people of the Virgin Islands in the office of territorial member, so help me God.
Honorable Archibald Christian has been duly appointed a member of the House of Assembly.
Can I shake a hand, please? Mr. Alvin Christopher.
I, James Alvin Christopher, do solemnly and sincerely affirm that I will be faithful and bear true allegiance to Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II, her heir and successor, according to law. I, James Alvin Christopher, do solemnly and sincerely affirm and declare that I will well and true service to Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II and the people of the Virgin Island in the office of member for the Second District.
Honorable J. Alvin Christopher has been duly appointed a member of the House of Assembly.
Honorable Dolores Christopher.
Honorable Dolores Christopher has been duly appointed a member of the House of Assembly.
Mr. Andrew Foy. To
I, Andrew A. Foy, do solemnly and sincerely affirm that I will be faithful and bear true allegiance to Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II, her heirs and successors, according to law. I, Andrew A. Foy, do solemnly and sincerely affirm and declare that I will well and truly serve Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II and the people of the Virgin Islands in the office of member for the 1st District.
Honorable Andrew Foy has been duly appointed a member of the House of Assembly.
Mr. Julian Fraser.
Excuse me. I, Julian Fraser, do swear that I will be faithful and bear true allegiance to Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II, her heirs and successors, according to law. So help me God. I, Julian Fraser, do swear that I will well and truly serve Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II and all the people of the Virgin Islands in the office of member for the 3rd District. So help me God.
Honorable Julian Fraser has been duly appointed a member of the House of Assembly.
Mr. Malin Penn.
I, Malin A. Penn, do solemnly and sincerely affirm that I will be faithful and bear true allegiance to Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II, her heirs and successors, according to law. I, Marlon A. Penn, do solemnly and sincerely affirm and declare that I will well and truly serve Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II and the people of the Virgin Islands in the office of member of the 8th District.
Honorable Marlon Penn has been duly appointed a member of the House of Assembly.
Dr. the Honorable Kedrick Pickering.
I, Kedrick D. Pickering, do solemnly and sincerely affirm that I will be faithful and bear true allegiance to Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II, her heirs and successors, according to law. I, Kedrick D. Pickering, do solemnly and sincerely affirm and declare that I will well and truly serve Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II and the people of the Virgin Islands in the office of member for the 7th District.
Dr. the Honorable Kedrick Pickering, Deputy Premier and Minister of the Ministry of Natural Resources and Labor, has been duly appointed a member of the House of Assembly.
Honorable Ronnie W. Skelton.
I, Ronnie W. Skelton, do solemnly and sincerely affirm that I will be faithful and bear true allegiance to Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II, her heirs and successors, according to law. I, Ronnie W. Skelton, do solemnly and sincerely affirm and declare that I will and truly serve Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II and the people of the Virgin Islands in the office of territorial member.
Honorable Ronnie W. Skelton, Minister of Health and Social Development, has been duly appointed a member of the House of Assembly.
Dr. the Honorable D. Orlando Smith.
I, Daniel Orlando Smith, do solemnly and sincerely affirm that I will be faithful and bear true allegiance to Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II, her heirs and successors according to law. I, Daniel Orlando Smith, do solemnly and sincerely affirm and declare that I will well and truly serve Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II and the people of the Virgin Islands in the office of territorial member.
Dr. the Honorable D. Orlando Smith, Premier and Minister of Finance, has been duly appointed a member of the House of Assembly.
Honorable Mark Vanterpool.
I, Mark Vanterpool, do swear that I will be faithful and bear true allegiance to Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II. Her heirs and successors, according to law, so help me God. I, Mark Vanterpool, do swear that I will well and truly serve Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II and the people of the Virgin Islands in the office of Attorney General in the office of the 4th District, so help me God. Wrong thing here.
be Attorney General. Change it. Mm-hmm. I'm initially.
Honorable Mark Vantipul, Minister of Communications and Works, has been duly appointed a member of the House of Assembly.
Honorable Myron Walwin.
I, Myron V. Walwin, do swear that I will be faithful and bear true allegiance to Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II, her heirs and successors, according to law. So help me God. I, Myron V. Walwin, do swear that I will well and truly serve Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II and the people of the Virgin Islands in the office of Territorial Member, so help me God.
Honorable Myron Walwin, Minister of Education and Culture, has been duly appointed a member of the House of Assembly. I would like to take this opportunity to convey apologies on behalf of the Leader of the Opposition, Honorable Ralph T. O'Neill, OBE. We ask God's continued blessing, and our thoughts will remain with him.
Item number 7, confirmation of minutes. Item number 8, announcements by the Speaker.
Honorable members of the Second House of Assembly, I would like to extend my sincere gratitude for your vote of confidence in me to serve in the capacity as Speaker of this Honorable House. And I offer my congratulations to all honorable members on their election to this honorable house. In honor of a country which has been a beacon of hope with justice, freedom, and liberty to all who are given the opportunity to call these islands home and from which I too have benefited, I am doubly honored to serve my country and this house as Speaker. I do not take this position lightly, being cognizant of the important mantle placed on my shoulders. I know that there are many expectations, but I can assure you that I will always aim to exercise impartiality and patience according to the ethical standards to which I subscribe, and I will lead the proceedings according to the rules governing this honorable house when we conduct the people's business. In return, I expect that all members will be respectful to your fellow legislator, put forward healthy debates, and actively participate in the decision-making process of the territory, and I will work tirelessly to assist you as together we work to maintain the integrity of each sitting and uphold the noble standards of this honorable house. Honorable members, I encourage you to read and to get to know the Constitution, the standing orders, and all other rules governing this House. They are the foundation from which we will begin our four-year journey. Set goals to pre-read, if possible, all papers relative to the order paper so that your debates can be robust and fruitful. This is the People's House, and it is fitting for the public to sit and observe the sittings and get to see how his or her representative is conducting business in this honorable house and understand how true parliamentary democracy works. If you were to adopt the words of one of my learned colleagues, you too will echo, "The Virgin Islands is our home, and we have no place to run when times are hard." So remember, the eyes of the Virgin Islands are watching how this honorable house will conduct the people's business. So in the lawmaking process, remember, your aim should be to work for the betterment of our home, the Virgin Islands, and I pledge to always guide the process in helping you to accomplish your aim. We live in a global world where we are connected by technology at our fingertips, and the world is watching. At the end of your four-year tenure, what message would you have sent to the people of the Virgin Islands? And what message would the world send to the Virgin Islands about the Second House of Assembly? I trust that it will be, "There goes a house where healthy debates were heard. The lawmaking body had effectively worked to shape the Virgin Islands into a better place for which all Virgin Islanders and residents would be proud." Again, I thank you for electing me as Speaker of the Second House of Assembly of the Virgin Islands. God bless the people of the Virgin Islands and this honorable house. Once again, good morning to all. I would now like to acknowledge the presence of visiting dignitaries. We have with us today the Deputy Governor, Mrs. V. Inez Archibald, and Dr. Joseph Archibald QC. Lieutenant Governor of the U.S. Virgin Islands, His Excellency the Governor of the U.S. Virgin Islands, Mr. John P. DeYoung and Mrs. DeYoung. Lieutenant Governor of the U.S. Virgin Islands, Honorable Gregory Francis Jr. and Mrs. Francis. Attorney General, Mr. Baba Aziz, Justices of the High Court and other members of the judiciary, Senate President of the U.S. Virgin Islands, Honorable Ronald Russell and Mrs. Russell, Senators Celestino White, Craig Bashinger, Neville James, and Terrence Nelson, other members of the U.S. Virgin Islands delegation, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for coming to the first sitting of the Second House of Assembly.
Item number 9, statements by ministers. Item number 10, presentation of papers.
I now call upon the Honorable Premier.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Madam Speaker, I beg leave to lay on the table of this Honorable House the following documents. 1, statutory instrument 2011, number 52, proclamation made under section 84(2) of the Virgin Islands Constitution Order 2007, proclaiming 13 September 2011 as the date on which the House of Assembly should be dissolved. Second, statutory instrument 2011, number 73, proclamation made under section 83 of the Virgin Islands Constitution Order 1976, appointing the time and place at which the first sitting of the Second House of Assembly shall be held.
Item number 11, reports from select committees. Item number 12, presentation of petitions. Item number 13, notice of motions given orally.
I now call on the Honorable Premier.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I rise to give notice that at a later stage in the proceedings, I will seek leave to move the motion standing in my name under item 16, subsection 1, Roman numeral 1, on the order of the day.
Item number 14, questions and answers to questions. Item number 15, motions relating to sitting of the House. Item number 16, public business, 1, government business.
I now call on the Honorable Premier.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. Be it resolved that this Honorable House invites His Excellency the Governor to appear and make an address.
I now call a short recess for 2 minutes.
I've never vacated.
I hear this coming up.
Solve that. I've vacated. Because I. That's why I have my vote. How's this?
Did you want to build the house?
I come to